Okay, so let's have a look quickly. How do you add a special, or how do you add something on your website that's not there currently when X3Web has built your website for you? So how do you add information or anything to your website? First thing that you want to do is you want to log into your client zone. That is clientzone.x3web.co.za. Then you add a back of your in your client zone over here. What you see over here, you're going to see all your domains. I'm going to edit the gamersx3.com domain. Let's log into Plesk. Once you've logged into Plesk, you are going to see all your domains listed like this. You're going to go to the domain that you want to edit. You press on there and you want to say login. Okay, it's going to log you directly into the back end of your website. Okay, so let's take a look at it. This is not an edited website. It's just a practice website where I can show you guys. So this is my website. Okay, so I've got a website over here. And we are going to edit this website. We want to add a special, or we want to add something to notify the clients, and I want to put it over here. What you want to do is you want to go on top here. You're going to say edit with Elementor. You click on Elementor. Okay, then it's going to go into the Elementor editor. Okay, so I want to go on top here. I want to add a special over here. So this is where I want to add my special. Okay, I don't want to edit these. I want to keep these as is, but I want to add. So let's say you press the plus button over here, and then you press the plus button over here. Okay, choose the flexbox, and now depending, you can either have a flexbox, a straightforward flexbox like this, or you can have one that's two sections like this, it's going to divide your screen into two, and we are going to use this one now, or like this, or you can have one that looks like this, but let's use this one over here. Okay, you see what I mean? It's going to split my screen in two, so I can add content over here, and I can add content over here. Now, I want to add two photos over here. Okay, so then you're going to say plus over here. And then you are going to say image, and you're going to drag the image over here. You're going to say yes. And then it's going to open up your images, and I want to add this image over here. And then from here onwards, I want to add another image over here. So this image is something that you could have created in Canva. It can be something that you have, or some work that you've done before, or anything in that line. You're going to say image. You're going to click on choose image there and add it. Okay, but now it added to the wrong part. So let's just drag it to the right place, and there it is in the right place. Okay, and then from there on, you want to update your website. Once it's updated, these images are now currently on your website. So let's just wait for the update to happen. And you're going to click on, you see on top here, there's three little lines where my mouse is. Press on that and you say view page. And now, as you can see, there's my images added to the website. Okay, but now you want to add text to the images or something like that. Okay, so let's say we go into edit with Elementor again. You're going to go to the bottom of these images. You see these three little dots? You press on there. And it's going to open this. Now, you see the text editor. Okay, you're going to drag that, and you're going to see wherever this pink is, that's where it's going to put it. Né? Okay, so there I want to put some text over here. And then sale, let's call it, it's a sale space, and I have a t-shirt on sale. So I have a t-shirt on sale, let's fix the spelling over there, but now it looks bad. So what you want to do is you want to go on this one over here, you want to change it, do not change it to an H1 header, I would suggest change it to an H2 header. I want this thing in bold, and I want this thing orange. You're going to press on here. You're going to look for the thing, and let's make it orange. This is going to be an orange. This part over here, I just want it bold, and I actually want everything in the middle. So let's highlight everything and let's put it in the middle. And then you've got some text happening on the bottom here. Obviously, you can customize this text. You can make it as nice as you want to. And then you can do the same over here. You say update. And now it's going to update. There's still a lot of other stuff you can also add onto your website. So let's go here. Let's go back. Yeah, so container, this is a container basically that you added. Okay, you can add a heading text. The heading text is something like that. This is a heading text. You can add a YouTube video. You can add a divider. You can add a button. So you want a button. Let's take a button quickly. You now on this thing here, you want this button to go to a specific product. And you're going to pull this button into here and you're going to drop it. And then you're going to edit the button. So let's click over here. Click here, let's say view more, and then the link over here, and you are going to say, so the link is wherever this website goes to. So I want the product, and let's just put in t-shirt over here. I've got a t-shirt product, men's t-shirt, and you're going to click yes, and you're going to say update. Once you have updated this part over here, and you say view page, this button will take you straight to that product over there. Okay, so let me show you guys. Let's say view page. View more. And there's the product with the variations and everything. Okay, so let's go back over here. Okay, now you want to go and you want to say edit of Elementor. Let me show you what you can add over here. Okay, so from here on, you can add the heading, you can add the image, a video, a divider, a button, spacer, you can even add Google Maps. Okay, you can add a share button, so let's add a share button. This is where they share it on social media, so when a visitor presses Facebook, Twitter, or LinkedIn, it shares it to those specific places. Or social medias, you can add a loop grid, a carousel. Let's practice with a carousel quickly. So now I want to add a carousel over here. Okay, let's delete this. Delete. Let's open up a new one and we make it a full one. Okay, so I want to add a carousel. Okay, let's use this one over here. Okay, post. I don't want post. I want products. Okay, so then you're gonna say products, and it's actually you have to create a template for what products you want to add. So create template, save changes, and then it's gonna take you to the template where you actually create a template. Okay, but let's delete this for now. Okay, let's see what else you can add over here. Your portfolio, let's say a gallery. You want to add a few pictures to your gallery, né? Why is it not allowing me? Give it 1 second. Update. Dun, dun. Let's reload the site. It's because I edited that part now. Okay, let's go through here. Okay, so let's now what you want to do is you want to add more stuff. Okay, so let's open up here. Let's say plus sign, and there's it. Okay, so we were at gallery. So we want to add a gallery. Okay, so gallery is a lot of images. On the side, you're going to see no selected images. You're going to say yes. And you are going to choose all the images that you want to add into that gallery. Okay, these are all the images, and here you can actually reorder them and put them in the order that you want to, ne? And you're going to insert, and there's my gallery. Okay, now from the gallery, you can order them randomly. You can say either grid, let's say justified. Okay, justified is going to give you the full pictures. Or you can say this one, let's see what this happens. Okay, then it makes it like this, but I do like the justified one. Okay, and you can add an overlay, so you can practice a little bit with this on the side over here. Okay, from there on, I want to add some more stuff. Okay, so let's say here, plus, and we want to add a form. So form is a contact form. Okay, but we actually use a different type of form. When you want to add a form, you let us know. Okay, general image box, you can image carousel, basic gallery, you can put a progress bar, you can put testimonials, accordion, toggle, you can put a SoundCloud link, you can put a shortcode, you can put a sidebar. So there's not really any limits here. Okay, so I want to put products, let me put my product pages into here, and there's a product. When a guy clicks on this product, it immediately lets him go to the product. Let's update. Okay, so this is basically how you edit your WordPress website, or how you add stuff to your WordPress website. I know my videos aren't the best, but I just want to show you guys a little bit about how it works so that you guys can go and practice and basically get stuff. If it doesn't work out, all you just say edit and you say delete, you go up and delete, and then everything is back to normal. Okay, but that's, you know what I say, practice makes perfect. Guys, I hope you have an awesome day, and let's chat soon.